Hi guys, I'm Paul Kubel Fiction. My name's Jay. I'm an actor, writer and director and a college student currently. And this is an evaluation that I was told to do and we were assigned to do in the assignment brief for the music videos. And this is about the ident. This is the clip that comes up before the music video, and also it's in the ident video, which is obviously you can go visit by clicking on Paul Kubel Fiction. Pulp Kill Fiction, sorry, on my name of this video. And then you can go look at my other videos if you wish. Currently all it is the Thor soundtracks and my Punisher trailers from it's December. Wow. December. So, and obviously you can go check out the Man Like Me music video, but please check it out because I'm quite proud of it. Where also the ident is also edited in before that. So, to talk about the ident, basically it came in the assignment brief and music video that we had to edit something into it before. So, the music video. So, I had to look up, well, what is an ident? What does it do? What is it, basically, if you don't know point blank? So, you had to go and look them up, and it's basically a thing where it pops up, like say for like the BBC 3, BBC 3, something like that. They'd have the big BBC 3 logo, and or for anything, you know, it'd be like Paramount, 20th Century Fox. It'd have that. It's just basically their ident, and it says who owns this video or who's showing this video for what channel or what company. It's basically that. Like JJ Abrahams would be Bad Robot, and that's the bad robot that goes around and picks up Ben. So yeah, it's basically something that expresses the genre of your film that you're making, or TV series or music video. So basically I had to express what I like to make, what I write, what I make in this 10-second clip, which I found quite a challenge. So basically I got it. I researched into some other ones, basically movie ones like film projects, like Paramount, 20th Century Fox, Warner Brothers, Marvel, DC. I looked at all those, and I started to design some. And basically, I couldn't come up with a finalized decision of one ident that I wanted to use and could use throughout. Videos and obviously my future project, hopefully. So I tried to look at things that interest me and entertain me in the movie industry. So I looked at James Bond, I looked at the Spiral one, and that was the only design that I made on paper. I made the design, it was a spiral and it just came out and bang, but instead of the blood coming down, it'd be a shattered screen. And it would come up with fading, and it'd be kabang, which obviously you see in the finalized idea, which I'll get to in a minute. Kabang, how I got the name for that company was it's a parody of Kerrang. For people who don't know, that's a big rock central place. You know, it's got magazines and TV, radio. It's rock central for us rock fans, so I made a play on that, and that was I thought that was quite fun to do, to make something up like that, instead of making like Jesus Christ Productions or Paul Kilgore Fiction Productions or something like that. But so basically I just worked on that and got Kabang, and saying Kabang, it kind of has a good, it's stimulating to say Kabang, so it's quite nice, so anyway, I got the name, and I started to design, got the Bond one, didn't really like it. I tried to do it, edit it, and I used After Effects to make my ident, and I tried to make it, and they had a program like Green Screen on YouTube to download it and use it, and I made it, and it didn't feel right. It felt cheap, it felt generic, it felt unoriginal, and I hate unoriginal. I love things to be new. So I didn't use it, I didn't end up using it, and So I made and started a new one from scratch. And I thought the genre if I chose to die for and to live my life watching for the rest of my life would be action. And something that's hard and true. And so I looked at, you know, because I'm a massive fan of Stallone and Die Hard, Schwarzenegger, all those, big fan, and superheroes as well, stuff like that. That's in all my posts, by the way, there's more of them. But yeah, so I looked at those, and I came up with, I don't know, it was weird, because it wasn't designed, it wasn't planned, it just came up to me when I was sitting down and I was learning how to use After Effects, editing, and Dan helped me, who's Daniel Allen, who you should look up his channel, The Dallin Show, you should really look him up. He's a funny guy. And basically, I looked around, I was looking for explosions, I thought, oh, I need to have explosion, and I have kabang. That's what got me, that's the thing. I thought, right, let's go and see how that leads to anything else I could do with that. And I basically came up with the idea of just, you know, a hard iron, you know, steel background. When I was on Google, I was looking through images and thinking, right, okay, maybe metal, that'd be cool. And then suddenly I started thinking about the Terminator, and I started thinking about the ching of something like hard steel being hit, or a blacksmith, like a really hard hitting, like in the first Iron Man as well, when he's making the suit, you can hear the ching, 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 you know, and that sort of noise, hard steel, it's really cool noise and everything. And I started to think about stuff like that, and I looked at backgrounds, got the steel one, the iron one, and then when I was looking for font, they had a Terminator one, T2, Judgment Day, and they had a font style like that, and I used that, and then I thought, well, instead of having no music and just an explosion, I got a section on YouTube from, because I don't own it, I wish I made it, I didn't, the T2, Terminator 2, music score, and I got a section for that, was which I think everyone knows, hopefully if you don't, you get off this planet now, and I used that, and I edited it all together, and it fit with who I am, it is, and my way of writing, it's hard hitting, it's fast, it's a big impact when you're first starting to sit down and watch it, it's an impact, you've got a big so I used that, and I just did it together, and that's what I got, and I felt quite proud of it, because I've never used edited anything that big, never worked with effects, so I'm not a computer generated imagery guy, I'm not CGI, I don't like that stuff, I love practical effects, I love that, and I used that, and I made it, and yeah, basically, and it fit, and that's what hopefully I'll be using in all my videos, and I liked it. The designs, not much design work, there was only one piece that I used, and I wanted to explain that in this video, which I hope will clear the air with that. Because really, it's like with storyboarding as well, they feel enclosed, they feel caged, and you just gotta let your mind just travel and be organic and flow when you're making something like that. And that's what I wanted to do, and I think that's what I got. So, thank you for watching. I hope this was a good evaluation. If there's any other questions, please comment or send me an email. This to you, Hayley, if you're marking this. But that's basically it I have to say about the iDen. My next one will be the music video, which I'll upload next. So thank you for watching. Any other questions, again, just comment. To you guys, normal guys, YouTube subscribers, please subscribe. Over the summer I'm going to make some special effects videos and other stuff, and post some stuff to entertain. So thank you for watching, guys. Bye.